Thank you again to all of our military members. McNamara, coached by Rick Zanini. Riverside Brookfield, coached by Brendan Curtin. Teeing it up for the Fightin' Irish, number three, Alex Willis. Here we go.
Welcome, everybody, to the RBTV game of the week. Sam Egan alongside Jake O'Brien as Brady Baia takes the return to the 30-yard line. Bulldogs will start with the first attempt from the 31-yard line.
Yeah, I
mean, big game tonight for both
teams.
Very
big game. So this obviously being the last game of the season, both teams, I mean, I want to say it's a must-win for the Bulldogs, but it's definitely a must-win for Bishop Mack.
Yeah, Bishop Mack, they're 4-4. They are fighting for a playoff spot right now. They need this win tonight.
They do need this win.
Whereas the Bulldogs, they're just fighting for playoff seeding, but that's still very, very important because they don't want to be stacked up against one of the best teams in the state heading into the playoffs.
Agreeable.
So first play from scrimmage. Novak is in the backfield with TJ Sloan. Novak is in motion. Sloan takes snap. Looking downfield, and he has a miscommunication there.
Yeah, definitely a miscommunication there.
Looking for Andrew Callis right there. Big 6'3 target.
Sloan obviously wanted to have a jump ball with his very tall receiver, Callis, and obviously not on the same page. Callis, maybe it was an option route there, but now second and long, second and 10 for the Bulldogs. So
looked like he had some options there, maybe with.
Oh yeah, yeah. He did scan the field, but it looks like he wanted their throw to Callis.
Yeah, he wanted that throw to Callis. Here you go, second and 10. Two guys in the backfield now. Sloan makes a handoff, screen pass to Brady Baia. It's a backward pass, so the ball is still live. Ball is still loose.
I think
Brady Baia recovered.
Yeah, the Bulldogs got back on it, but
that was a bad play.
That was ugly. I mean, obviously, so to those who do not know, when they throw it, it was a throw, but it still was backwards.
So it's still
a fumble. Yeah, it's a live ball. And that, I mean, yeah, it over his head. It didn't even look like Baia had much to work with, even if it was caught. So now you have a third and
22.
Forever.
Yeah, it was a 12-yard loss on that play. That's not a good start for the Bulldogs, especially against this tough Bishop Mack team who they've never beaten before. So they needed a fast start, and they're not getting it.
Yeah, for sure.
Sloan going deep to throw. His throw is complete. No, it's dropped by Anthony Petrucci.
Petrucci got lit up on that play. I mean, he definitely could have caught it, but it would have only got back the stick. So now it's... Obviously, they're going to punt it on fourth and very long, like I said. A horrible start for the Bulldogs. I mean, can't get much worse than that.
30-second drive, and you're already punting.
Yeah, and looks like the Bishop Mack's going to have some good field position if this punt is fielded cleanly. So
yeah, but don't down Iggy. Iggy has quite the leg.
He does have quite a leg.
The punter. He's had a few punts that have just gone over the returner's head, so let's see if he has it right here. It's a high snap. Iggy gets it off. And he'll pick it up from the 44. Breaks a tackle, flag on the field. He's brought down by Callis.
Yeah, it was definitely a block in the back there. I mean, the gunner, I think it might have been Vinny Maeda. He made a great play and got past his man, but definitely got blocked in the back. So it's going to be a 10-yard penalty back.
For sure. And that's big because they need all the yards they can get.
Oh, yeah.
Because Bishop
yeah.
Mack, as they trot on this field, big, big offense, very run heavy. And
yes.
they're led by running back Tony Phillips.
Yeah, he's got three big one, big D1 offers, one being from a SEC school, which is...
Correct. He did get offered from Tennessee.
Yeah.
He's only a sophomore, too. 5'6",
yeah.
so you may look at him. He's not that big.
No, he's
only
not
5'6", but he is built, and that is
oh my
why he
gosh.
Has the Division I offers.
Yeah. I mean, he is 170, and he bring. I mean, he's just
he's
fast.
He's very explosive and tough to bring down, too.
Yeah. I mean, I'd be very surprised if Bishop Mack doesn't run the ball here, honestly.
Yeah. He has a lot of runs that he can just take to the house, a bunch of 50-plus yard rushes.
Yeah.
As they hand it to the fullback.
And RB doesn't want any
RB's
of it. I mean, good
it.
Stop there. Now second and seven. Still a couple-yard gain, but good to see from the front seven of those Bulldogs to stop that run play.
Jaden Wright is the fullback for Bishop Mack. We haven't really seen much of him this year, obviously, because Phillips is taking the spotlight. But
yeah.
Wright is still a solid running back. He's also a sophomore, though, so that
oh,
is
yeah.
a stacked backfield
yeah,
filled with young talent.
And he's a very good blocker, so.
Oh, that team is going to be set up good for the future as Phillips takes the hand off. That'll be a gain of seven. It looks like they're going to give him the first down.
Maybe
he's a yard short, and he is.
Yeah, he is. I mean, but from Phillips there, we saw great vision. Great blocking as well, but, I mean, I'm guessing they're just going to run the ball the whole game.
Yeah.
It's going to be hard, tough to stop, but we'll see. Like, but when you have a solid run game, it opens up your pass game with play action and
for
bootlegs.
Sure.
So
for sure.
I'm curious to see what they do here.
It's the hand of Phillips. Breaks a couple tackles, and he will get a gain of three and a first down.
Yeah, that is enough for a first down. Novak was in the backfield there, but just missed him. But now
it's tough to bring down Phillips.
Yeah.
Usually takes a couple guys to bring him down because he will break tackles, and that is why he's such a dangerous runner.
He will break tackles and run by you. So.
Anthony McCudis on the stop, first and 10 Irish.
Haven't seen a pass play from Fighting Irish yet today. So.
No, you have not. So very early, though. As Phillips takes the carry on a stretch route, breaks a tackle, breaks another tackle. He's still going.
I mean, that showed his elusiveness pretty much there. He basically just
cheated on a first down
yeah.
for sure.
I mean, I didn't think he was going to get much yards on that, but he made that look easy.
Yeah, he makes it look easy.
Yeah, I mean, like we said, he's very small but so shifty and will be a problem for RB tonight.
He will be a big problem, so the offense just has to respond.
Yes.
Because I feel like we can have a high-scoring affair here tonight.
Mm-hmm.
As Phillips takes another handoff, and he is brought down in the backfield. Big tackle on the play. Looks like it was by Marcus Moody.
Great tackle there. Looked like a swarm of Bulldogs there, but Moody being the first one there.
It's a loss of one. Bulldogs needed that for sure. Second and 11. Maybe this would be a good time to bring out a play action. What's your thoughts on that?
I mean, that would be a very good call. I mean, I'm guessing still going to run the ball here, but definitely do not be surprised if they're going to try to shot here on second and 11.
I feel like at some point you got to bring out the pass just to at least try and throw off the defense. And
yeah.
as I said, bring out the pass. The pass is incomplete. Good coverage there from Iggy Beliobrodek.
Yeah.
And now it's third and long.
Looks like the throw was there, but Iggy with almost blanketed coverage. And I couldn't see if it was drop or not, but that's a good play. Now you're at third and long. And would be a huge stop from RB right here.
Oh, this would be huge. But can't count out the fact that they won't go for it.
Oh, no. Oh,
you're
this
too
is
close to punt, and you're too far to go for a field goal.
Yeah, it's definitely four down territory, and I'm guessing to see a short play here from Bishop Mack to get close to the sticks and then bring him a fourth and short.
Or Phillips maybe breaks off a big run here. As there's some movement along the line, let's see what the call is.
And it's a false start.
It's a false start.
So that pushes Bishop Mack even more back.
Bulldog fans love the call.
Yep.
I am expecting this place to get loud right now. This is
yeah.
a huge play.
This is a very big play. Third and long for Bishop Mack. I mean, what RB needs to do this game is, like,
limit
they
the
need,
run.
Yeah, yeah, limit the run, and as well as offense, they need time. They need
long possessions.
Yeah, and controlling the clock is big in this game because you do not want
to
leave this.
Give the ball to Ryan Novak.
Yes, yes. For sure.
Play action. Bertrand's throw. is caught. Big gain on the play. Colton Promise, the receiver there. Iggy locked him up on that second and 10, and he just went out and got dusted.
Yeah, it was a double move on Iggy there. It was the same exact play that they called on that third and 11, but then they got pushed back more and felt confident with it, and obviously it worked for them, first and goal now.
Yeah, that's a real...
Double moves are very difficult to guard.
Tough play to guard. As Phillips takes the handoff, he will be short of the end zone. Gains two. Now it's second and goal from the one.
Yeah.
That hurts the Bulldogs a lot. That was a big play.
That was a big play. I mean, that was a perfect throw from Brady there. But, I mean, you can't. That was a great play call from Bishop Mack, and it obviously panned out, being now second and goal. So,
for sure.
I mean, Phillips is most likely going to get the ball here, or even the fullback. So,
I don't think I see a wide receiver out there.
There's not.
Or with their heavy set, the give to Phillips, and he will get in there with ease. Yeah, touchdown Bishop Mack, and it is already 6-0.
Untouched. Phillips just could walk in the end zone there.
That's just great blocking right there.
Yeah, very, very good blocking. And now Bulldogs going on 6-0. I mean, they need a statement drive right now, because they had that one couple plays where they were stopping Bishop Mack, but the rest of that drive was mostly with ease.
Yeah, the Bulldogs have been struggling the last two games. They've lost their last two, so this is a big game for them, and this is a big time for TJ Sloan to have that statement drive.
Yeah, and you definitely do not want to go into a playoff game against a really good team. Yes, against a really good team. And, I mean, RB has to show something here, or it'll be a tough night. But
for sure,
there's still a lot of football left. And RB,
if they go out and get a big score here, then all of a sudden you're looking at a new game.
Yeah, I mean, it was the first drive of the game. Yeah, struggles come there, but... Like I said, a lot of football left, and there's a lot of room for improvement. So
see how TJ Sloan responds to this, because he's had a lot of drives where he either responds poorly or he responds very well.
Yeah.
You looked at what he did in that Morton game, he responded very well.
Yeah.
There's games where he responds very well. There's a reason the Bulldogs have a winning record and they're in the playoffs.
Yeah, I mean,
part of that is TJ Sloan.
He's a very talented pocket quarterback. I mean, he can't move. He does have wheels, but he's very, very good when his first read is open.
Yeah,
which is likely with quarterbacks in high school. But when your first read is open, it's very easy to succeed.
As Ryan Novak takes it, he's a very dangerous returner. He's at the 25, the 30. He is down at the 34-yard line.
Very solid return there from Ryan Novak.
That's a solid field position.
Yeah, very solid field position. It was a short kick, and Novak got the ball in his hands for the first time this game. So,
oh, and look at this. Diego Gutierrez is heading into the game.
Wow.
A quick leash there for TJ Sloan.
I guess so.
Did you expect this at all or no?
I was not expecting this. I'm guessing it's just going to be a switch off the whole game.
Honestly, yeah, they might just be switching out drives. See what Diego can do. As Diego drops back to throw, he throws for Callis. Callis makes the catch. He's fighting for yards. It's a gain of about five on the play, five or six.
Solid
play. Makes it second and manageable.
Yeah. I mean,
I think this is where you go to Ryan Novak.
Yeah. You got to put the ball in one of your best players' hands. But, I mean, Diego, I'm very surprised from that move from Curtin, because I thought TJ had a good chance to have a successful drive. But
I did too. I mean, yeah, TJ made some rough throws, but, I mean, I thought he would respond big to that, so
yeah.
We'll see what happens here. As Diego once again is in the backfield, Gutierrez and Novak. Hand off to Ryan Novak as expected. And he will get back to the line of scrimmage,
yeah.
Third and four.
Really nothing to work with there. Not any hole even to go through, but now that leaves you third and short still. I mean, it's not a third and long like last drive, so.
Definitely doable.
Yes.
Now,
and you can open up the playbook with this a lot more than third and long, so.
I know it's early, but do you go for it here on fourth down?
No. I don't think so. Unless it's fourth and one or shorter.
Unless it's fourth and one, I agree.
I don't think it's too early to do that, especially on the own side of your field. So
play action. Diego rolling now, and he is sacked for a big loss. Loss of six, goes back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, it was, I mean, no one was open. Blitz was in there, and another.
Saw Anthony Petrucci maybe getting open downfield, but by that time, there's way
not enough. Yeah, not enough time to get the ball down the field. So, and they, yeah, they, obviously they are punting here. Iggy, the second time punting today. 2 3-and-outs for the Bulldogs. Not a great start.
No, but I'm sure they will bounce back. As Iggy, with a boot of a punt, Turner picks it up at the 25. Another flag on the field, and he is brought down. No return there, and they may lose even more yards.
I think it's going to be another block on the back for Bishop Mack. I think they kind of did a little, I don't know if it was enough to call it, but they definitely pushed Drew Swiatek there a little bit, and they're leaving the flag on the field.
There are some discussions amongst the officials, so we'll see if this sticks or not.
And they are calling a block in the back.
There's another block in the back. So that'll draw him back.
So two block in the backs for Bishop Mack on the special team. And, I mean, special teams has not been looking good for Bishop Mack, but their offense and defense has been looking good. So, now it's going to be first down from around the 22-yard line. So
that's a 17.
17.
Oops.
My bad. Tough to see from the press box.
A little bit.
Another I formation for Bishop Mack now.
Yeah, I expected a lot of that tonight. As Phillips takes the carry, and he breaks through. There he goes, the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10, and that is a touchdown for Bishop Mack.
Wow.
Tony Phillips, what a run. 83 yards.
And he got to the zone pretty quick. I mean, that breakaway speed.
He broke through that right away. Looked like he didn't really even get touched.
No, he maybe got touched at the line, barely, but.
That's a great play.
Yeah.
Great play call. What blocks from that offensive
line? Yeah,
line.
That was a gaping hole from the running back. So for the running back. And, I mean, breakaway speed, there it was. I mean, saw it firsthand. He basically just turned on the jets, and no one was even going to catch him. Like, there was no chance. So.
And here's Mills out for his second extra point. Oh, and they run a fake. The throw is intercepted, so the two-point try is no good. Little trickery there.
I mean, I guess so. It didn't look like the snap was bobbled or anything, but
Jackson Roberts, the wide receiver, he was out there to throw.
Very, very, I'm confused on that call there. Maybe it was a botched snap, but
I don't think that it looked like a botched snap to me.
No, I know. That's weird. But I'm guessing to see Sloan on this drive. Like,
I am too.
I'm guessing to see a mismatch and like changing it up every drive unless the quarterback
there needs
has
to
a
be
solid
a
drive.
Big play from this offense because
or
that
just
was a quick turn of events.
Yeah, or a couple solid, like, to get past the chains is big for the Bulldogs right now.
They just got to get a first down. Once they get one, get more confidence going.
Yeah.
And just get your defense some rest.
Yeah. Especially after a long play like that. I mean,
a long drive followed by a quick 3-and-out, then a long play. I'm sure that defense is gassed.
Yeah.
As Vaya will return it from the 10. Breaks a tackle at the 15, the 20. He's still on his feet. The 25-yard line. Down at the 27.
Brady Vaya making nothing out of something. Or making something out of nothing. And gets back to the 26-yard line. So, I mean, I didn't think he was going to get anything there.
No, it looks
because he was waiting to see if the kick was going to go out of bounds because it was right in that area, but it didn't. And now Diego is sticking. Coach Kern's sticking with Diego here. Wow.
Guessing Diego must have had a very good week at practice.
Yeah, something like that. Or TJ maybe did not have a good week. I don't know.
Diego takes a snap, Play action. He's going to keep it.
And
he maybe gets 1 yard
yeah.
there.
I mean, nothing to do there. Good. I like the play call. Trying to switch things up
yeah, a bit.
Yeah, and have a very mobile QB try to have open space, but nothing to work with there.
Pick up of a yard, second down and nine.
And, I mean, RB being very pass-heavy this year.
Yeah.
I mean, very pass. They had a game
and
where
Bishop
they threw.
Mack is very rush-heavy, which big issue with RB is that they've struggled against the run
yes,
this year.
Yes,
big time.
Very much so.
And with RB being so pass-heavy on a night tonight, like tonight, where it's pretty cold.
Yeah, it's a little chilly outside.
Diego play action. He's in trouble. Somehow makes the throw to Novak, and Novak cannot make the catch. However, there is a flag on the field. It looks like it'll be pass interference against Jeremy Deuce.
Wow. I mean, that's a way to get yards. It was a
tough
little
play from Deuce there.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it was good coverage all the way around, but
I'll have to call that on Deuce or Alex Willis.
Yeah, it was definitely a PI, though. And
Bulldogs needed that play badly.
Yeah, yeah.
But what a play from Diego to break out of pressure. What a throw.
I mean, it was a little underthrown, but Novak really wasn't that open. So,
yeah.
It was – at least you're getting positive yardage.
That could have been very dangerous.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You somehow got that throw off where
– And Novak being as athletic as he is, making a play on it to
obviously – to draw the penalty.
Yeah. And now no running backs back there.
Diego by himself in the backfield. Diego looks like he's going to keep it. He's throwing downfield for Brady Vaya. Incomplete. Just a bit overthrown.
That's a very good throw, even though it wasn't completed. Going to his left.
Yeah.
And obviously his righty.
I feel like he could have
set his feet.
Not only just set his feet, but I feel like he maybe could have taken off and gotten a few yards there.
He did have open space, but, I mean, Vaya was open, had a step.
Vaya was open for sure.
Barely overthrown. I mean, that's a good play call. And, I mean, getting the ball.
Diego's a very young quarterback, only a sophomore, but we have noticed a little bit of overthrows is kind of an issue.
Yeah.
And I'm sure with him getting older, he's definitely going to improve.
Yeah. He's very young, like you said.
Young, so I'm sure that'll get tuned out, but definitely a little bit of an issue.
Mm-hmm.
As Diego takes a snap again, delayed handoff to Novak. Novak breaks a tackle,
and
but cannot go anywhere. Loses yards, loss of three. It's going to be third and 13.
Yeah, I mean, this run game has not been no push up front for the Bulldogs O-line to, like a couple games ago at home where it was just a blowout against Westmont where the run game was very successful. But
very. Now you can't open the run as much because Bishop Mack's a little bit of a bigger, better team.
Yeah, for sure.
Now you have a third and long. What do you expect Gutierrez and the Bulldogs to do on this play?
I mean, or a deep hitch or a slant from one of these guys. I don't expect a deep shot.
Throws a Novak, and it is intercepted. Marion Parnell looked like he was there with the interception. That was just not a good read from Diego right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, I mean, he wasn't open. That is a great play by Parnell.
He was looking for Novak, and Parnell was just all over that.
I mean, Parnell read that play perfectly, did his job, and was there for the interception. So that's now gives Bishop Mack great field position. And, yeah, I mean,
this could get ugly.
Yeah. But there's still a lot of football left.
There's still a lot of football left, but the way this first quarter is gone is not looking good.
Yeah.
Back to throw. It is. Did he make that catch?
He was just out of bounds.
The ref rule is incomplete. Provost looked like he was there once again. Beat Iggy again in coverage.
I mean, obviously it did look like he beat him, but obviously, the sideline is another defender, so it's incomplete. That's all that matters. And now, second and 10. Iggy might have gotten beat, but not caught. So that's all that matters for the Bulldogs.
Good throw by Bertrand,
now.
Though.
Yeah, that was a good throw. On his outside shoulder.
Another big run from Bishop Mack. This time it's from Jaden Wright, the other sophomore running back.
Yeah.
As it looks like he'll be a yard short of the marker, it'll be third and one.
Third down and one, pick up a nine.
I mean, the backfield besides the quarterback is sophomores. So, I mean, Bishop Mack's future looks very bright.
Yeah, and they're led by a senior quarterback. But, yeah, like you said, the rest of their team is a lot of sophomores on this team. Including Provost, the wide receiver, he's also a sophomore.
Yeah, and he's gotten two targets already.
As Wright will take the carry, gets the first down.
Jadon Wright on the carry once again.
Enough for a first down, but that still solid stop from the Bulldogs. But
four, Fightin Irish first down.
But I mean, that moves the chains for Bishop Mack. So
first and 10, Bishop McNamara.
Now they're at the, looks like the 27 yard line.
First and 10 at the Bulldog 27.
Yeah, 2 minutes left in this first quarter, and we'll see how the Bulldogs can respond as Wright takes another carry. And he is fighting for yards. He's still on his feet.
Yeah.
We're finally being brought down at the 21.
I mean, yards after contact has been big for Bishop Mack this year. And shown right there, he basically got hit at the line of scrimmage and still gets a gain of about 7 yards. So,
yeah, as Tony Phillips checks back into the game, he was out for a couple plays.
Yeah, I mean,
maybe thought there was an injury, but no, he's back out there in the backfield.
Hasn't seen the field since that long
since
run.
Since that long touchdown,
so.
Correct. As no gain there. Bulldogs defense was right there.
Yeah, miscommunication or something
Bertrand,
there.
And I think just wanted to keep it, and he had nowhere to go.
Yeah. I mean, the blocking, it looked like they just let the Bulldogs D-line in. So now that leaves us third down and short for the Bulldogs. Or for Bishop Mack, seeing if the Bulldogs can get a stop here.
Yeah, the Bulldogs have struggled on third down this year, though.
On defensively, yes.
So we'll see what they do here. I'm expecting a run to Phillips. Bulldogs fans are making some noise as he's going to throw. It is deflected by Iggy Bealy-O'Brod. A good coverage there. He was looking for Jackson Roberts there.
Yeah, that was great coverage from
Jackson
Iggy.
Roberts, another sophomore.
Yeah.
So you got two sophomore receivers and two sophomore running backs.
Who are very involved with this offense.
For sure.
But, I mean,
I was shocked to see Bertrand make the throw there.
Yeah, he was nowhere near open, but Bishop Mack still going for it on fourth and short here.
Bertrand's going for it. I'm sorry, Bishop Mack's going for it. Three backs as the give to Phillips. And look at that speed.
Yeah.
He's going to go walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Bishop Mack. Tony Phillips.
Yeah, untouched. I mean,
touchdown of the game already.
Yeah. And you can't get much easier than that. He just ran in the end zone with ease. And he is very, very talented. And I'm curious to see how his high school career ends up. Being already having three D1 offers, so
yeah, for sure.
But now it's 19-0, Bishop Mack.
Mills, he'll kick it this time, and it'll be good, making the score 20-0.
And
a little bit of a rough start,
yeah,
for the Bulldogs.
A little bit.
But Tony Phillips, we were talking about him a lot, and he is proving why he's such. Such a hot topic.
Yeah, he's obviously, we're talking about him for a reason, so he's showing that he's worth the time to being talked about and thought about. So, I mean, he is just so shifty and fast.
I think what's scary is Bishop Mack, if you're looking at them, they're 4-4 right now.
Yeah.
They're fighting for a playoff spot, and they're really trying to get in there.
Yeah.
And I think they're trying to make a statement, and honestly, they could shock some people in this playoff run,
yeah,
led by their sophomores.
I mean, they have a very tough schedule playing St. Francis and ACCP.
St. Francis, ICCP, Cole City. Bunch of solid 4A teams.
Yeah.
Thank you also for your dedication and determination.
And ending the year with RB, too. So,
congratulations.
RB has had a tough schedule, so we'll see what happens as they go into the playoffs. As the kick to Novak turns it from the 15, he's going to be tackled at the 31-yard line, and that's where the Bulldogs will start with 13 seconds left in the first quarter.
And let's see, TJ Sloan's back in the field.
Coming back out there. Diego had a turnover in there. No, I mean, the offense hasn't looked great. Their only first down has come off a penalty.
Yeah.
So you want to keep switching things up and hopefully find something.
Yeah.
But the
thing,
the Bulldogs offense just cannot seem to find a rhythm right now.
Yeah. Yeah. I was surprised with the Diego, with Diego coming in. Oh, looks
as
like
TJ Sloan gets the defense to jump. Looks like it was Jared Salzman who got him to jump.
And there's
the big defensive line.
Yeah, the refs are discussing
now
if it was a jump on the offense or the defense.
I think I saw a big number 73 jump.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's offsides against Bishop Mack. There you go, first and five.
Yeah, Bulldogs free five now.
5 yard walk off.
I mean, you take any yards you can get now.
Honestly, yeah. If you're TJ Sloan, do you want to try and take a shot down the field, or do you want to just try and get to the sticks?
I say a bootleg or just a run up the middle to see, because first and five, you have a lot of room to work with.
For sure.
You can open up the playbook for sure.
Sloan hands off to Vaya, and Vaya is met immediately in the backfield.
Right when he touched the ball.
And now it is third and 10 to end the quarter, or second and 10, as that'll end the quarter. So the yards gained on the penalty are lost.
Yeah, it was a tough quarter for the Bulldogs, but need to show something on this drive.
For sure. There's definitely a lot of work to do, for sure, to say the least.
Yes, to say the least.
Once again,
honestly, I mean,
time, Riverside Brookfield High School would like to recognize all
there's
their
so much that could be improved upon right now.
Yeah.
Offense is struggling, defense is struggling. Tony Phillips is doing his thing.
Yeah.
What do you think is the biggest key for the Bulldogs to just get the rest of this? Because there's three quarters left. They can bounce back.
Yeah, there's a lot of time left in this game, and it's not a blowout yet. 20 points is definitely not a blowout, but it's
a doable comeback, but you got to improve on a lot of things.
Yeah. And their defense had a, like, they've looked horrible at points, but also they've looked good at points.
Yeah.
And so you just have to trust and trust your practicing and see what you can do and have confidence. You still need to have confidence in these games.
From their own 31.
So,
TJ Sloan's back there once again. Second and 10 to start the second quarter. Expect a no change. TJ Sloan trying to drop him or get him to jump off sides. He's going to drop back. Looking for Novak. Overthrows him. He had nothing going there.
Yeah.
That Bishop Mack defense has been very, very solid.
Yeah, they have been clamping.
Ryan Novak, the intended receiver,
3rd and 10. TJ Sloan, he went through his reads. Nothing was there. And obviously tried to dump it off to his check down being Ryan Novak, but overthrew him. He really didn't have much to work with, even if he did catch that ball. So. Now it leaves a 3rd and 10. After having a 1st and 5, 3rd and 10 now.
Yeah.
Not a good look.
No, not at all. TJ Sloan in trouble. He's going to take off. And he's going to, looks like he's going to get the first down. And a late hit penalty after the first down. This may be the spark the Bulldogs need.
Wow, that was.
What a run from TJ Sloan.
TJ Sloan.
He's not really
Sloan.
Much of a runner.
Yeah. I mean, I said at the beginning of the game where Sloan.
If he has to use his legs, he will.
Yeah, he will. And that was a very that's a great play by TJ Sloan.
That is a great play for sure.
I mean, great play. Nothing open. He tucks it up and runs it down the sideline and gets extra 15 yards from.
Now you're in Bishop Mack territory.
Yeah. I mean, great play from TJ Sloan.
Yeah, Bulldogs need a score on this drive, and they need to hope they can stop Bishop Mack defensively, because Bishop Mack, as an offense, they will run up the score on you. They beat Elmwood Park 77-7, so they've proved that they will run up the score. And despite that 77-7 win, they still are negative in the
plus minus points
differential.
I think they're minus 13, so.
As following the penalty, it'll be first and 10 from the 43. Let's see what TJ Sloan can do here. Some movement along the defense, but no flag called. TJ's in trouble again. He's trying to break out of it. He makes a throw to Brian Toomey, but he'll lose yards. Lost to five on the play, and Brian Toomey honestly would have been better off dropping that ball.
Yeah. But as a player, it's hard. It's
hard in the moment for sure to do that.
It's obviously a lot easier to watch from here to see. It would have been better if he dropped it, but as a player, he had his back towards the other way, so that
very impressive that he got that ball away, though.
Yeah, that was...
Because he was met by one guy, then met by three.
Yeah, and he was getting thrown around. That was... At least he didn't lose 7 yards, you know? Then he only lost six, so... Oh, wow.
They give to Vaya. Nobody there. He's going to get a big gain out of this. He's still going at the 30, the 20. Big first down for the Bulldogs. Big gain. Gain of 28.
What a play call there from Curtin. I mean, a reverse play, and Bishop Mack was fooled, and that's a huge gain. Great blocking upfield from the Bulldog wide receivers.
Now the Bulldogs are in the red zone. They're cooking up something here.
Yeah. Big drive for the Bulldogs so far. You have to end this in points.
And that was that big TJ Sloan drive I was talking about.
Yep. That we thought that was going to be the second drive of the game, but now being the fourth. And now
empty backfield looks like. Maybe I'm expecting Ryan Novak to be in motion.
Maybe not.
Maybe not. He won't be in motion. Sloan throwing deep for Callis. He makes the catch and a penalty marker. What's the call on the field?
It's definitely on the defense there. But I think the refs are just...
said the ball was intercepted.
Oh,
wow. Did Callis not come up with that ball?
I thought he did. It was a great throw from TJ Sloan. Giving the
it looked
big...
like Alan Smith might have just ripped it out of his hands.
Yeah. But there was definitely a penalty thrown.
There was
the
a
refs
flag
are discussing
sure.
it.
Flag is down at the 1 yard line.
I mean, they are two big shots attempted for Andrew Callis here, being one of their biggest guys in their team, height wise. And the refs are still discussing here.
Let's see what we got. Looks like the ref is pass interference against the defense. Bishop Mack does not look happy with that call.
Yeah. And that's another.
Looked like Smith might have pushed off, though.
Yeah. Another big penalty on Bishop Mack to now put the Bulldogs in first and goal.
Yeah, penalty, or it was an interception, but because of the penalty, it's called back. But I honestly thought he.
I thought he caught it. I thought he caught it. As well, but
first down and goal to go Bulldogs
still first and goal for the Bulldogs now. And that was a great throw from Sloan there,
for sure. See what Sloan does here. Novak in the backfield. Back to Novak. Sloan throwing. Incomplete.
Sloan pass.
He's looking for Brady Vaya right there.
That was a little fade route there from Vaya. It was a solid throw under pressure from Sloan, but just out of reach for Vaya. They really have abandoned this run game after it hasn't worked. Which I mean, it has
not working. You can't go with it, obviously.
And now Novak in the backfield as well as Sloan.
Yeah. Give to Novak. Novak will get
Ryan maybe Novak a yard.
Gain of yard there.
Yeah.
Give that stop to number 33.
And now that leaves a third and goal at the 8 or 9 now.
Third down and goal for the Bulldogs.
Gain of one there.
And
you look for either Luke Kumskis or Brian Toomey here. Luke Kumskis is a big target.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised, but I think it's going to go to Vaya here. Maybe a corner or another fade here or slant, but they're definitely going with a lot of their
two tight ends lined up on the right side.
Toomey on the right side in the middle.
Novak in motion. Empty backfield here. He's going to throw for Petrucci. The ball is incomplete.
Pass is incomplete. It was
Alan Smith was there on the coverage.
That was just perfect coverage there from Alan Smith. And the offense is sticking out there. They're not going to kick the field goal. But
I feel like it's you're down 20-0 against a high-powered offense. It's too late for field goals.
Yes.
It's either you make them drive down the entire field or you get a big score here.
Yeah, this would be huge if the Bulldogs put the ball in the end zone here. Huge.
For sure. Got Callis. I'm expecting to throw to Callis here.
Yeah, maybe
or
another
Baya.
One.
Throw to Baya. Baya looks like he might throw. Baya is in trouble and loses 6 yards. And that will be a turnover on downs. Bishop Mack will take over first and 10 from the 16-yard line.
Jared Salzman.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Yeah, that was – I was not expecting – I thought it was definitely going to be a shot at the end zone. But it looked like they were trying to –
maybe the play you go for on third down.
Yeah,
not
fourth
down. You got to try and go for the end zone.
Because, I mean, Vaya was trying to throw the ball. He definitely looked like he was ready to throw.
He didn't have anybody.
Yeah, but he had no time to throw it. He got hit basically a second after he got the ball. But I say you go to Kells there, the big body, and see if he can get a catch down.
Get a catch or a pass interference.
Yeah.
Row is complete.
And that's
Jackson Roberts is there, the sophomore.
Good defense there from the Bulldogs, basically gaining
gain of 8. Yeah, that's a big gain there.
It looked a lot shorter than I thought, but good throw there from Brady Bertrand. So now that leaves the second and short.
Yeah, Bertrand's looked pretty solid this game. Yeah, for such a run heavy offense, he's made some good throws.
Don't be surprised if they take a shot here on second and short. Don't be surprised.
Wouldn't shock me either. As Phillips is in the backfield, it's Jaden Wright once again. As Wright takes the carry, and he just plows through, looked like he didn't have anything, gets a gain of 3 in the first down.
On the carry, number 22, Jaden Wright.
I don't know if we're going to see much of Phillips more of this game because, I mean, 3 touchdowns already, but he might get some playing time at the end of this quarter, but I don't see him going in on this drive. Now first and 10 for Bishop Mack. Running back switching sides.
Back keep throw. Bertrand's throw is caught by Roberts, but brought down by Ryan Novak.
Novak
after a gain of 2.
Novak guarding that perfectly as a linebacker. And he's a guy that can run sideline to sideline. Obviously, he plays running back as well, so you know he has some good speed. But he's a great coverage linebacker as well as run stopper.
Tony Phillips is back in the game.
Oh, wow. I guess I was wrong.
Yeah. I mean, it's only 20-0. I don't think you put away your best running back in a game that's only 3 possessions, at least in the first half. Mm-hmm. As they give to Phillips. Breaks a tackle. It's brought down at the 41-yard line. Brought down by Brandon Tennicott.
Solid tackler from Tennicott. Trying to lower his shoulder.
Penalty mark on the play.
Tennicott on the stop.
Let's see what the call is. It's a hold against Bishop Mack. So that takes away that first down.
It looked like that's a great open field tackle there by Tennicott, though. I mean, tackling Phillips in the open field is very difficult itself, and him doing that.
I feel like despite the penalty, that tackle will be used on the huddle film from Tennicott.
Maybe. You never know.
Because that's a great tackle on a big running back.
Yeah.
He's not big height-wise, but he's big and strong and Division I running back.
Yeah.
Second down and 16 yards to go.
Now second and 16 for the Fighting Irish.
We've seen, though, that long, second and long, or third and long hasn't stopped anything so far as there's
flag
movement still
the
along the line. Penalty marker on the field.
I've noticed that Bishop Mack is getting to line very quick.
Yeah.
And they're trying to run a a quick offense and gets the line quick, really just trying to catch the Bulldogs off guard.
One thing I've seen so far, Bishop Mack has a lot of penalties in the Bulldogs zone, which I feel like that'll cost Bishop Mack in the playoffs.
Yeah.
As that's another penalty against Bishop Mack. It's a false start.
Yeah.
So if you were to look at this game and you're looking at the penalty yards, you think, oh, the Bulldogs are dominating this game. They don't have any penalties. But no, Bishop Mack is dominating despite the many mental errors.
Has not been the case. I mean, Bulldogs drives have been extended. That's what they've been extended with penalties, obviously. But besides that, Bishop Mack has been
very
solid.
Bishop Mack has been backed up too. That hasn't stopped them, however.
No.
As a throw from Bertrand, I know he's gonna delayed handoff. He's still going, breaking tackles.
And
Jaden Wright once again on the carry.
Anthony Mkuda's going in now for the Bulldogs.
What a carry from Wright, making it third and manageable.
That was a great play call, getting back to the sticks, being third and 10 now.
Yeah, it looked like Bertrand was in trouble, and he just gave it to Jaden Wright there.
Mm-hmm.
It's a big play from the defense here. They got to get a big stopper here.
I don't think Bishop Mack would go for it in the side of the field, unless it's fourth and short.
Third down and 10.
Right in motion from the right side to the left side. Bertrand back to throw. Bertrand's throwing deep. And it's caught. What a catch from Colton Provost, diving out to make the catch.
Wow, what a catch from Provost, and what a throw from Bertrand. I mean, Bertrand, it was a – that was a dot.
That was a dot.
Obviously, Provost having to dive for it. It was just a great overall play.
Gained a 33 on the play. And that, once again, a big third down conversion for Bishop Mack.
Yeah, I mean, they've had a couple. This game, for sure.
Give to Phillips. He loses it. He's brought down by Drew Switek, but the ref's saying it's an incomplete pass.
It was an incomplete pass because I've never really got, like, this play is used in the NFL a lot as well as college, is the little shovel pass right to the running back, which it is considered a pass even though it's right there.
Right there.
But that's a – honestly, that's a smart play because if it is dropped, then it's a gain of zero.
I mean, if shovel pass has been very effective in the NFL. Look at a guy like Aaron Rodgers. He makes that throw a lot.
Yeah, he does make that throw a lot.
As he fakes to Phillips, gives it to Wright. Wright loses a yard, and it's now third and long once again.
Yeah, he had nowhere to go.
Bulldogs defense looks much improved from that first quarter.
Yes. Except for that third and long conversion, but it was still almost dropped. It was
as Owen Murphy is trying to pump up the crowd on the sideline, expecting the Bulldogs fans to make some noise. This is a very big play right here. Kind of a long drive though.
Yeah.
35 minutes and 30 seconds left. He's back deep to throw again. Hit as he throws. Deflected by Marcus Turner. Big play by him. And that'll make it fourth down and 11.
That was a great play by Marcus Turner. A little underthrown, but Marcus with that recovery speed and breaking that play up.
And Bertrand just a little bit underthrown, but
that was still a very talented.
Looking for Jackson Roberts right there.
Yeah, it was open for a second, but like I said, the recovery speed from Marcus Turner was big and almost intercepted it.
Almost.
And
it's fourth down, and they're staying on the field.
Yeah, they are staying on the field. Most likely a pass play here.
You would think.
Hey, the running game has worked for the Fighting Irish.
Bertrand's throwing deep again. This time for Provost. Tennicott's there for the coverage. Provost looking for the flag. No flag. Great
and
coverage by Tennicott, and that is a turnover on downs.
Yeah, that was great coverage from Tennicott there. Wanting the flag, there. I don't think that was even close
to
PI.
I think that was clean coverage.
Yeah, it was
there after the ball was there.
Yeah. And now that's big for the RB defense, even for the, obviously, team crowd to try to get back into this game.
I mean, they had a great drive last time. Obviously, didn't result in any points, but now TJ Sloan out there again after the big drive, and
yeah,
see if he can make a big play and get them into the end zone.
They showed last drive that they could move the ball, so that's
give
big.
To Maeda. Maeda, gain of 6 yards, switching things up a little bit. Vinny Maeda coming in for Ryan Novak.
Yeah, a lot different of a runner than Novak, being obviously a lot smaller than Novak, but still packs a punch and is very fast. So Maeda is staying out there.
And why not? I mean, yeah. It worked. See what TJ Sloan does here. As give to Maeda again. Gain of 5 and another first down for the Bulldogs.
I mean, great vision there from Maeda with that big jump cut and burst it for a first down.
See the find something in the defense there.
Stop is made by number 17, Marion Parnell.
Most likely another run play here. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
I wouldn't be shocked to see either like a play action or a bootleg from TJ Sloan here, though.
Or take a shot. I mean,
take a shot to Brady Vaya.
He's in the slot here.
Sloan's going to make the pass to Anthony Petrucci. Gets a gain of 4 yards there.
A little hitch play by Petrucci, the sophomore. And I mean, it's a gain. It's a solid gain.
Just keep getting yards.
Yeah. And you need this defense to have a break after that huge stop. So
for sure.
With three minutes and 55 seconds left in this second quarter, so very manageable to get the ball in the zone here.
For sure. Maeda is still in the backfield. Sloan throwing for Maya, overthrows him. It's picked off by Alan Smith. And he might go all the way, and he will. Touchdown, Bishop Mack. Pick 6 from Alan Smith.
Wow. I mean, overthrown there from Sloan, and Smith takes
like
advantage of it.
The Bulldogs had something going. Big stop. Had a good drive, then a big stop. And then.
And then.
And a pick 6.
Yeah. I mean.
This is thrown right to the defender.
Yeah, Alan Smith basically. If he just had outrun Vaya there for the touchdown, because. That's a tough throw to make as a quarterback, though. Like, he had to move on up in the pocket and make that throw, but still no excuse for that. Now 26-0, Bishop Mack. 27 make it.
And Schwartz good, 27-0.
Yeah,
big change of events right there.
Yeah, very big change of events.
Jackson Mills, extra point up and good. 3:30 remain in the first half of play.
Yeah, I mean, Harvey was moving the ball, and it seemed like they were confident moving the ball as well. I mean,
they were, yeah.
Sloan looked confident back in the pocket.
I still think you stick with TJ Sloan, though.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
He's looked much better, and he's been solid all day.
Yeah, except for that last throw.
He's been making plays. Mm-hmm.
And now,
honestly, you just have to take this one play at a time.
Yes.
One play at a time. You're looking at the scoreboard, it's like, oh, it's 27-0, so
before
obviously
half.
It's a lot. And it's going to take a lot to get back in this game, but take it one play at a time. Make
RB
it respectable.
Hasn't looked as bad as 27-0.
That first quarter, yes, it looked like, yes, they definitely looked like what the score was. And then they came out the second half, or the second quarter, I should say, mm-hmm. and they looked like a much improved football team. They looked like a team
a
that
different team.
Could come back in this game, make some plays, and I mean, they haven't allowed a point to Bishop back in the second quarter.
Yeah.
Now, granted, it's been one drive, but their only points have come on the defensive end.
Yes. And now RB needs to take care of the ball this drive, having two turnovers now. I can't speak. But
it's definitely one of those nights.
Yes, definitely.
Alex Willis
sees
it up.
Willis's kick. Breaks a tackle and is down at the 38.
Both of us,
Jake,
huh?
You're rubbing off on me, buddy.
My bad. Solid turn there for Fire. Gosh.
Rough night.
Yes, rough night so far.
Bulldogs have good field position, though. First and 10 from the 37.
Yep.
as Diego Gutierrez comes in the game. I'm not as shocked by this.
Yeah.
I would think TJ Sloan would be the better move here. However, Diego is also a very solid quarterback, and we'll see how he can lead this offense with 3.5 minutes left.
And Novak is back in the backfield. Maeda having a solid drive, but Novak is their one of their best players, so.
Gutierrez under pressure again. Breaks a tackle, and he is sacked.
I mean, that is a coverage sack
loss
there.
Loss of 10.
That is definitely a coverage sack for Bishop Mack. Good. I thought it was solid pass blocking there from the Bulldogs, but.
Yeah, he had time, but I don't think he had anyone open.
Yeah, he had
He tried to make something out of nothing, tried to make a play for himself, and he was met by a defender.
Mm-hmm. Now that leaves a second in about 16 now. Or, like, 18. Trying to make him jump.
From off sides, for sure. As give to Novak. There's a big miscommunication there.
Yeah, I mean, Diego going back and running right into
Novak. Bumping into each other.
It was. I'm guessing it was trying to a draw play, but he just ran right into each other.
25-yard line.
Now it's third in a country mile.
It is third and very long.
Yeah.
22 yards isn't exactly manageable, but Diego definitely does have the arm talent to make a big throw.
Yeah. Don't be surprised if you see number 15 down the field here being Brady Vida. Brady Vida.
As the give to Novak, just trying to gain some yards. Novak. It's a gain of 4, so it's 4th and 18. As will Iggy Beeler-Braddock come onto the field? Hold on for that. Timeout, Bishop Mack.
Yeah, Bishop Mack's trying to put the ball in the end zone or even get points with only a minute 38 left. So they want to make it. They want to make it even more of a lead so they can maybe put the backups in for the second half.
Just get ready for the playoffs.
Yeah.
And I think Bishop Mack, their big key, if they want to make a big playoff run, limit the penalties,
yes.
Limit the mental mistakes.
Yes, for sure.
Because they are a very solid team.
Yeah. And
they
definitely have the talent.
A lot of talent. Mm-hmm. You have a Division I running back. In a division like 4A, where the talent isn't as high, mm-hmm. and you won't have as many Division I players, a solid running back like that can get you a deep playoff.
Yes, run. Easily. And being how run heavy a lot of teams in the NFL or in high school now, Bishop Mack usually being run heavy, it could make a playoff run. Don't be surprised if Bishop Mack is deep in the playoffs.
Booms his kick, fielded at the 30-yard line. Now at the 35. Brought down at the 40s. There's.
It's like
appeared
Maeda
to be a Bulldog
there.
Down on the field.
Got his shoulder. Maeda's pointing at his shoulder.
He's limping off the field. That's not a good sign.
Yeah. Him being their best, one of their best corners.
Bulldogs are already like a thin team roster-wise. They don't have a big team like as far as like how many players they have on their team.
Yeah.
And they've lost a bunch of guys. Owen Murphy not playing this year because he's on the Team USA baseball team.
Mm-hmm.
You have Peter Sofesky out with a torn ACL.
Philly
Vizzana out,
yeah.
Torn ACL.
Matt Novak.
Gio Gonzalez out tonight with a concussion. Matt Novak out, torn ACL. So the injuries are very, very high for this Bulldog team, and it's not getting any better. It's Jaden Wright. Big run, 50, 40. Jukes out Iggy Beeler-Braddock, and he's brought down
by Drew Switek.
By Drew Switek. Big run, though.
And now that basically flips the field there for Bishop Mack. With a minute 20 left try to get in the zone and make it even more of a lead.
Yeah, again, they do have the reputation of running up scores against teams, beating Elmwood Park 77-7.
Mm-hmm.
So the hope is you can at least try and limit them. As
timeout, Riverside Brookfield.
There's a timeout called by Coach Curran and the Bulldogs.
Mm-hmm.
Don't forget,
defense seems to be out there,
fundraisers
a lot.
Yeah.
Like, If you look at the time of possession, Bishop Mack is just dominating that because they're such a run-heavy team.
I mean, besides that one drive with the 83-yard touchdown from Phillips, they really have controlled the ball and had moving drives. And but I mean, RB had that one good drive, and that's really it. So makes sense Bishop Mack has had the ball for basically the whole game, it seems like. The defense has struggled, but they've had flashes where they've looked really good, being that one that stop where Bishop Mack tried to throw the ball downfield. And no wide receivers out for Bishop Mack now.
Going with the big set here at the 24-yard line as Wright takes it. He's brought down by Marcus Turner. Big tackle by Turner.
That was a great tackle. Great tackle by Marcus Turner. But it looks like he's
letting the
running
clock run.
Turner, pick up a 2 second down and eight.
Turner heading off the field.
Needs water or something here.
As Miguel Garcia comes to the game for him. As Bertrand's going to throw, he's throwing for the tight end. And he makes the catch.
Wow.
Touchdown, Bishop Mack. Michael O'Connor having called his name all day.
Yeah, that was a great play call there from Bishop Mack. But he was wide open. But Tennicott got back there and tried.
It was too late.
Yeah, too late.
Yeah, touchdown pass goes to number 86.
I mean, he was basically open besides that last play. But still got the touchdown, having very strong hands there to make that catch.
Yeah, O'Connor, the tallest guy on their team, only 6'1". But he's big target out there and made the play.
The extra point kick.
As the extra point is good, it's making it 34-0 with 24 seconds left in the half.
Yeah. I'm guessing RB's going to maybe try to. I don't think they'll try to run a play.
I think they'll just kneel it, go to half.
And
hope to build on something
in
the second half to make it respectable.
Mm-hmm. Brady Bertrand, so number 86, Michael O'Connor, extra point.
I mean, RB being in the red zone only one time this game and not converting. And, I mean, Bishop Mack has basically scored out of the red zone most of this game on big plays, so Maybe Via or Novak tries to bring one to the house here, yeah, but I don't really see RB trying to run a play on offense.
No, I don't either. You don't want to risk an injury.
No, not at all.
Especially with how thin the team is already. Mm-hmm.
And Maeda, I don't think he's
I haven't seen him on the sidelines since the injury.
And he was pointing to his shoulder when he was coming off the field. It was on the pump play.
Yeah, I was going to mention that on the drive. I couldn't find him on the sidelines. Yeah, mm-hmm. He's still not on the sidelines, which is a scary, scary sight for the Bulldogs. Another one of the leaders who they cannot afford to have out because they already lost Novak as Zvaya fumbles the snap or fumbles the return. Gets a gain of 12 there.
The return stop is made by number 25, Jackson Roberts. First and 10 Bulldogs,
looks like they're going to stick with Gutierrez on this drive.
Maybe run the ball, but I don't see a pass play. Not at all.
I don't see them trying to take too big of a shot.
No.
As Novak's in the backfield as well as Toomey, so yeah, expecting a run. Novak takes the carry. Gain of 4 on the play.
Brian Novak
that will most likely be half.
And that'll end the half. Your score is Bishop Mack 34, the Bulldogs 0. A struggle of a first half for the Bulldogs as Bishop Mack just dominated this game, led by their future D1 running back, Tony Phillips.
Yeah, with 3 touchdowns.
A lot to take away from here, but what's your biggest takeaway from the Bulldogs?
I mean, take t- They have time of possession, in my opinion. They have to show that they can drive the ball down the field.
I agree. Well, this is the RBTV game of the week. We will be right back after halftime. Stay tuned.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the Riverside Brookfield High School Marching Band to the field for your halftime entertainment. The RB Marching Band is directed by Mr. James Baum and Mr. Matthew Lowe. The color guard is coached by Ms. Dawn Lysak. Leading the band this year are drum majors Claire Harrison and Al Sylvie. The band would like to extend a special thank you to all of our military personnel present tonight, especially recognizing those who were once members of our band and those serving in the military as musicians currently. While we all have been concerned with other things in the news over the past year, no one has noticed another rising threat, the rise of the machine. The RB Band is here to rescue you from the uncertainties of AI revolution. We will show the daftness of Daft Punk. We will pacify a case of rage against the machines. And we will say domo arigato, but no thank you, Mr. Roboto. All of your delights. And now please enjoy the debut of this year's halftime show, Rise of the Machines. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the RBTV Game of the Week. I'm Sam Megan alongside Jake O'Brien. We bring you inside the broadcast booth.
Yeah.
As just a rough first half for the Bulldogs.
A little bit. 34-0. Nothing horrible.
There's definitely a lot of negative you could take away, but there's definitely some positives. Defense looked better in that second half. The offense got a little going.
In the second quarter,
They had some trouble stopping Tony Phillips the first half. They have since really not gone to him much and have instead gone to Jaden Wright, who has also had a pretty good game. But the Bulldogs defense definitely has improved.
Yes, for sure. I mean, their offense had that one good drive where they got inside the 5, or inside the 10 it was, but not much besides that. Their offensive possession, 2 turnovers, 1 being a pick 6 for Bishop Mack, but not a great start for a first half. But, I mean, there's still 2 quarters left, but the Bulldogs at least want to put some points on the board, and this is their last game of the year in regular season, so you want to get something positive out of this game if you can get any positive, really. So
for sure, what do you think is the biggest thing the Bulldogs need to do to have some positives heading into the postseason?
Control the ball, and they need to be consistent on offense with what they do. The play call has been solid, but there's been a couple plays where I've been confused about. But their third down conversions. Their third down conversions are what their problem is on offense.
And they have to make the
defense stops
on third down.
Yes,
for sure.
Yes. And
who do you expect to see to start off the second half?
TJ.
I agree. TJ Sloan, I mean, his last home game as a Bulldog.
As a Bulldog, yeah.
So I think he's going to finish this out, and I think he's going to have a strong second half and try and feed something into the playoffs.
Yeah.
As the Bulldogs are going to kick the ball to Bishop Mack to start the second half.
I'm pretty sure RB deferred when they got, I think they won the coin toss and
Bishop
deferred.
Bishop Mack won the
coin toss. Oh, they did. Okay,
toss,
okay.
They deferred to the second half.
Okay. Teed up for the Bulldogs.
So Iggy Bieler-Braddock is back deep to kick. He's made some big plays on the defensive end.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's tough defending these Bishop Mack receivers. They're young sophomores, but they've made some great moves.
Yeah, and the secondary has looked solid for the Bulldogs, passing wise. So
for sure, Iggy had a much better second quarter.
Yes, he did.
Let's see what he can do. Him and the defense can do as he kicks it off to start the second half. To return from the 11-yard line.
And Brady Vaya making the tackle there.
Is brought down at 31, Roberts. Like you said, brought down Brady by Brady Vaya.
First and 10, opening possession of the second half.
So let's see if they, A, bring out Tony Phillips, and B, if they stick with the same quarterback, they stick with Bertrand, or if they go with a different option at quarterback.
I'm guessing to see Bertrand here.
At 32, first and 10.
Wait. Oh, no, Bertrand's still out there.
Bertrand's still out there, and I believe I still see Phillips, too.
Phillips is not.
But he's in there as a wide
receiver.
Not
in the backfield, yes. Right, staying in the backfield as he did last drive.
Bertrand's going to throw. Throwing to the big tight end. O'Connor is fumbled. Pennicott forces the ball loose as Marcus Moody recovers. As Moody
and
a little physical down there.
Yeah, on the Bulldog sideline, it looks like Moody said something to number 64 being
Dalton Koska as he stood over him. I mean, it's 34-0, so I don't know if you should be doing that in that game.
He poked the ball loose.
So
it was a great play.
He definitely did take some exception to it, but what a play by Brandon Tennicott to start off the second
half. I mean, literally right there. First play of the second half, getting the ball now at the 28-yard line. So big start for RB this second half.
As Gutierrez is out there to start the second half. As advances 5 more touchdowns. As Gutierrez is throwing to Iggy. It's complete, and Iggy's still going. He's going to go to the 10-5 touchdown. Iggy Bieler-Braddock. What a play to start the second half.
Wow, RB just 2 plays in a row. Huge.
What a start
for the
second half.
That's a flip of a switch. I mean,
sure.
Right.
Iggy Bieler-Braddock, look at the wheels on him.
Oh, my
gosh. I did not expect that. Look at those wheels.
Yeah. When he found those blockers,
he just got going.
Yeah. I mean, wow, what a great start after the second half.
I saw him do that a couple weeks ago against Westmont, and I'm like, ooh, Iggy's got some wiggles.
Yeah.
Really proved it against a little bit of a bigger defense. Big play to start the
second
half.
That was huge for RB.
as Billy Braddock is now out to attempt the extra point. And his kick is good. Automatic, 34-7.
It took two plays. It took two plays for RB to get in the end zone.
One on the offensive end. Yeah. One on the defensive, one on the offensive.
I mean, wow. That gives some energy for the for this Bulldogs team as well as the fans.
Brought some energy to the booth as well.
Yeah. A lot of energy, actually. Tough to announce a 34-0 game, but now, I mean, it gives is some leeway to open up, you know?
For sure, for sure. I mean,
wow. I mean,
that was fun.
Yeah. Now 34-7, but that's big.
Only
I mean,
four touchdowns.
Yeah,
now.
I mean.
Four touchdowns.
Close enough.
Three extra points, and you got to tag it.
It only take 8 plays to get back in this game. if we're doing the same range.
Is Belia Braddock? Oh, he goes for the outside kick, and it looks like Bishop Mack may have recovered it.
Iggy
Belia Braddock. Pat McAfee there.
He almost got it back.
Got it there. But it is recovered by Bishop Mack.
That was close. That was a good onside kick there from Iggy Belia Braddock, but. I mean, wow. Well, that gives the Fighting Irish very good field position, though. But RB, maybe their defense now after a big turnover. Let's see if they can continue to try to force Bishop Mack to turn over the ball.
As Phillips takes the carry,
it's a solid
gain of five.
Yeah, five or six.
On the carry, number 8. Tony Phillips, stop is made by number 35.
And that, I mean, now Petrucci coming in for Iggy Bula Braddock. Seems like Bula Braddock's on every.
Yeah, he's all over.
Yeah, he's on offense, defense, special teams. He basically plays the whole game. So he needs a little break there after.
Great all around player. Does a lot for this team.
Yeah.
Bertrand heads it off to right. Right gets a gain of two. Now it's third and two.
Stop is made by number 44,
Brian Toomey there
with
the tackle.
The senior making a good tackle there.
For the Fightin' Irish. The ball will be spotted at the midfield strike. Third down, 2 yards to go.
Third and two now for Bishop Mack. The fans making some noise to try to get a big stop here. To help try to make them.
Definitely is four down territory for Bishop Mack. I would think.
Oh, yeah.
Flag is thrown.
It's going to be a false start on Bishop Mack.
Uh-oh. Looks like Marcus Turner is jawing at Phillips.
Start against the offense. 5 yard walk off against
they're letting them. They're letting them talk.
Letting them play. Let the kids play.
Yeah, let them play.
Third down and 7.
We've seen like a couple of times a little players have been jawing at each other.
For
so.
Sure.
They're not calling it.
We definitely saw it a bit during the St. Edwards game.
Yeah, for sure. In the first half, especially, that was a lot of John.
Sideline is fired up, making some noise. See
Looks
what
like
the
a
defense
blitz.
Can do here. Give the Phillips as he gives it to Roberts. As Roberts breaks a tackle from Petrucci. Still on his feet, trucks Marcus Turner and is brought down at the 25.
I mean, that was a very good play design. Very good play design. I mean, everyone expecting to go to Phillips, then reverse it, and he had wide open field in front of him with a lot of blockers as well. So huge play and basically silenced this crowd. So
first and 10, Fightin' Irish.
That brings a first and 10. Around the 25, 6-yard line for Bishop Mack.
What they do here is Bertrand gives to Phillips. Phillips is brought down by Switek and Turner there.
And Turner continuing to talk.
Stop is made by number 13, Marcus Turner, along with number 23, Drew Switek.
That's a gain of about 5, 4 or 5 yards there.
Four, second down and six.
That's just been Bishop Mack's offense all day. Gain 4 or 5, mm-hmm. just gain yards, and then third down, get a conversion.
I mean, and Bishop Mack has had a lot of big plays. I mean, passing and running.
Oh, for sure.
Being one of the 83-yard touchdown, that big play on third down to Provost. So there's been a couple of big plays.
Fakes the handoff. Throwing deep. Just out of the reach of Provost. Bertrand was looking for Provost. Could not find him.
He was open, but just overthrown there from Bertram.
Looked like he beat Brandon Tennicott there, but no harm, no foul.
Yeah.
Third and six. Let's see if the Bulldogs can make a third down stop. They've been struggling all year with that, so let's see if they can finish the job here. As the crowd started to make some noise again. Right in the backfield. Bertrand, screen pass to Roberts. Still on his feet.
I think his fight gives enough for the Fighting Irish.
There's a late flag thrown. Bullock fans seem to be clapping. I did not see what happened, though.
Yeah. Let's see what the refs are going to call here.
I would think with the late flag would be an unsportsmanlike. I think he was short of the first down anyway.
Oh, he was short, yes.
Short by about a yard, so let's see if they get backed up anymore. Again, talked about Bishop Mack having a lot of penalties today. After the play, unsportsmanlike against Bishop Mack again.
Yeah, like, I mean, you said they need to be more disciplined, this Bishop Mack team.
If they want to make a big playoff run, for sure.
Yeah,
they've been struggling with their discipline.
And with these unsportsmanlike contact.
Unsportsmanlike conduct?
Yeah. the refs see the retaliation. They don't see the first maybe drawing or push. But when you retaliate, that's when they throw the flag. So you just have to stay disciplined as a team and not get those dumb penalties.
Yeah, for sure. Because that brings teams back into games.
Yes, it does. I mean, that brings a fourth and about 16 instead of a fourth and two.
Fourth and one. You either have fourth and one or fourth and 16.
I'd say that's a pretty big difference. A little bit. But, yeah, I mean, obviously going for it, that's too far to kick a field goal. And
for sure.
Yeah.
But we've seen they can break off huge plays before. Let's see if they do it again. Bertrand throwing deep. It is incomplete. He did not throw deep. He was looking for the screen. I thought he was going to go deep. He did not.
And that's a stop for the Bulldogs.
That's another stop for the Bulldogs defense. Thought he was going to look deep.
Yeah. That, I mean, maybe momentum brings RB inching back at this game. I mean, it's never over till it's over.
For sure.
And Diego staying out there for RB.
I mean, they just had the one play drive that led to the score, but
yeah.
I mean, brought him points.
Mm-hmm.
Gutierrez, play action to Novak. He's throwing for Novak, who has a ton of room on the screen at the 40, the 50. He's brought down at the 49-yard line, it looked like. Big gain, another Bulldog first down, gain
great.
Of 18.
Great block set up by Jax Ramos as well as CJ. And, I mean, good play call there.
Yeah,
screen.
Good play call. You saw Ramos and Zaninski.
Yeah.
They were pretty far downfield.
Yeah, they were pretty far downfield.
And they just had those blocks set up for Novak.
And that was, good throw to you. Those are the simple throws you have to make as a quarterback, like screens and digs and as well as checkdowns. You have to make those throws.
Looked like Toomey may have moved. They didn't throw the flag, but then they threw it a little late.
Flags down before the snap. False start.
But it is false start against the Bulldogs.
5-yard penalty, first and 15.
So that brings as the Bishop Mack fans have something to cheer about. I haven't heard much of them all night, despite the fact they've been winning
dominating,
by a lot.
Yeah.
Guess they're feeding off the Bulldogs fans' energy.
Yeah, I guess so. And Diego and Novak in the backfield on this down.
Gutierrez takes a snap. Throwing for Vaya. At juggle and incomplete.
Pass intended for Brady Vaya.
almost a dangerous throw there.
Yeah, that was almost a dangerous throw. If I didn't really get his hands on that, the Bishop Mac defender would have an open lane to the end zone. Now that leaves a second and long now. The Bulldogs need to get somewhere to get third and manageable here. Maybe get another screenplay, you never know.
I mean, it worked the last time. It worked the last two times, actually.
Yeah.
Beeler, Reddick, and Novak, so see if they can get some blocks up downfield. Or if they take a shot. As Gutierrez under pressure, he's going to take off. He's going to get back to the original line of scrimmage, gain of five, and now you have a third and 11.
Solid play there from Gutierrez to get to the outside and get back to the line of scrimmage, like you said. I mean, third and 11 now about, but.
I mean, just getting yards, because
yes,
it definitely
yes.
is now
for
down
territory. Yards, you need to get yards almost every down. Obviously, some plays being incomplete, but this is a play where you try to find a guy like Kallis or Vaya, in my opinion, or even Petrucci being the wide out. So you got to
see Kallis on the field,
yeah,
so I think they're going to go with Vaya here. As Gutierrez under pressure, met by a swarm of Bishop Mac defenders. Just both came from the outside.
Yeah, Bishop Mac just
big loss.
Design blitz and no one to help out the blitz there. Diego had zero time to do anything, and now the punt team comes out for the Bulldogs. I mean, that momentum was stopped by that false start by Toomey, but great teams conquer those small flags. Great teams conquer those small flags.
For sure. Beeler Bruddock is going to
boot it
downfield.
Yeah.
As Roberts takes it, 20. Another flag down on the field. He's still going on his feet at the 35. Brought down at the 43-yard line.
Breaking like
flag
four
down
tackles.
At the 20-yard line.
Yeah. Looks like it's going to be on Bishop Mac.
Looks like the third block in the back penalty of
all on
the
punts.
Game.
All on punts. Yeah, it was. Their special teams has oddly not looked good.
Legal block against Detroit Irish.
The third illegal block in the back this game by Bishop Mac. Now that pushes him back even farther now.
Let's see. Flag occurred at like the 20-yard line, so. Believe
it's a 10-yard penalty after that.
Man,
they're
like
gonna
they
get
it put at the 10-yard
yep.
line.
All right, this is a time where the defense can step up and put their offense in great field position, if they can create a turnover.
Hand off to Phillips. He's brought down at the line of scrimmage, though. Big play there.
Great tackle from Luke Kumskis. I mean, only forces a guy like Phillips 1 yard. That's great.
Get your 50-50 raffle tickets out. We've got the winning number. It's on a white ticket. We'll call that winning number after this next play. Once again, it's on a white ticket.
Second and 9 here.
$200 to that lucky winner.
Looks like
no
wide
receivers out.
They're going to run the ball here. As Phillips, patient runner, fighting
yeah.
for yards, and he gets a gain of 9. Good enough for that first down as there is an injured Bulldog on the field.
Officials timeout on the field.
Cannot see who it is right now, but.
Phillips' carry was good enough for a first down.
Yeah, that was a first good run from Phillips. Very patient to get
Here's
the first down,
ticket.
But
it is on a white ticket. The number is 0977.
Can't see right now who is down on the field,
Once
but
again, on a white
I think
ticket,
it might be Billy Robrodick, but I could be wrong.
Yeah,
I don't see him in the huddle, and I don't see him on the side.
It looks like it's Switek. Yeah, it's Drew Switek, the junior. But he looks like he's walking off the field okay now. Looks like he's pointing to his arm.
Another upper body injury for that Bulldog. For that Bulldog defense.
Yeah.
Plus Maeda earlier.
And Switek being one of their leading tacklers, being an outside linebacker.
Him and Novak both leading the charge on that defense, so that would be a huge loss for that defense.
Yeah. Just
already losing Maeda,
who's one of their best coverage corners.
As Novak was there for the tackle. It's gain of two, making it second and eight.
Stop is made by number 22, Ryan Novak, along with Luke Kumskis.
Yeah, Luke Kumskis has made a couple tackles this drive. And
three on the play, second down.
He's a guy that has very high potential for this Bulldogs team. So another no wide receiver out. They're just looks like it's they're going to try to ground and pound here.
Feeding it to their star running back as Phillips takes it again. And he's still on his feet at the 40, at the 50, at the 40, just break it through everybody. 30, 20, 10, touchdown. Tony Phillips and Bishop Mack. Another big, big run. This one for 75 yards.
Yeah.
What a run.
Yeah, I mean, he just ran past everybody, read his blocks perfectly, and took it to the house.
Tony Phillips, man, that is a special talent.
Yeah. Imagine if this was a fantasy points, he would have a lot. So, he's got four touchdowns.
Can I put him in for fantasy? I got like 8 guys on a bye this week.
Yeah. week 7 bye. Like, I don't know why there's so many players, but yeah, he's having a huge day.
For sure.
Two big runs and 4 touchdowns. So,
as the extra point is up, almost blocked by Turner, but it is good, making the score 41-7.
Wow, that mean he just turned on the burners and. I mean, great blocking there. We didn't really talk about that.
Right.
Downfield blocking there was fantastic.
Been great all day.
Yeah. We don't give enough credit to the big guys.
No, we don't. I feel like the big guys as a whole just do not get
enough.
Oh,
yeah. Not at all. Not at all.
Once again, 50-50 raffle ticket if you got it. 0977-260.
Losing Drew Switek on this defense is not good. Maybe he'll go back in the game. He's getting wrapped up on the elbow. So, curious to see if he's
honestly,
okay.
I don't think you risk him trying to get back out there.
But as a player, you always want to.
You always want to be out there for sure. You want to be out there competing. But I think there comes a point where you're like, you got to get ready for the playoffs.
Yeah.
See what you can do. I haven't seen Maeda on the sidelines either.
He pointed to his shoulder when on that pump play, and I think he maybe fell on it wrong or something, but.
Alex,
that's not a good sign at all.
Not at all. He's a big, big part of that Bulldog defense.
Yeah.
Him and Tanaka are the seniors leading that Bulldog defense as Baya will return it. In the 15 at the 25, at the 30, at the 35, the 40, the 45, the 50, and he'll go out of bounds at the 49-yard line.
Great return there from Baya. I mean, a little stutter step and getting it outside, getting the 50-yard line, that's huge. That is huge. Oh, and Sloan is going to take this drive here for the Bulldogs. After seeing two drives after half by Gutierrez and now going back to their senior Sloan. So, and with great field position, so.
Let's see what TJ can do with the great field position.
Mm-hmm.
Ryan Novak in the backfield. Obviously, no Maeda. So they're just going to stick with Novak for the rest of the game. As Sloan throwing for Billy Obradek. He makes the catch. Staying on his feet, going the wrong way.
He got spun around and ran the wrong way, but.
Loses, or I'm sorry, he
He gained yards.
6 yards, but he lost probably 2 yards there.
I think they're calling it forward progress. So he still gets a gain of six.
It looked like he caught that ball around the 42.
Yeah.
That's a good play. You need to get those big chunk plays.
Yes, you need to be on first down, especially.
A big part of this offense the second half.
Yes, on first down especially, you need to get somewhere in management.
I think Iggy Bielabrata could be a huge piece for them during the playoffs if he can make these plays on offense at the receiving end. As Sloan is brought down for a loss of two, that'll make it third and six.
And looks like a Fighting Irish player is down on the field being... being Caden Martin. And, yeah, he looks like he's in pain. Hope he's
like
okay.
He's in a lot of pain.
Yeah, hope he's
he
okay.
He went down immediately and started banging on the turf.
Yeah.
Which you hate to see.
No,
this.
No, you never want to see. You never want to see. But looks like Switek's okay. He's talking to his teammates on the sideline. And I'm pretty sure he wants to go back out on defense, but like you said, you don't want to risk anything.
For sure. Injuries suck. They just take the life out of the stadium.
Yeah.
It's just
take the life out of this press box. It's tough. It's tough.
And we don't have the luxury of being able to go to commercial break like these college and NFL kids. So we just got to keep the conversation going.
Yep. And, I mean, injuries are... for this RB team have been...
they've hurt. I mean, when you look at their roster to start the year, they already had a very, very small team.
Oh, yeah.
Comparatively to some of the teams they were playing this year.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just look...
and they lose one of their biggest and best players.
Week two, you lose your star wide receiver,
Matt Novak,
the game-winning... week one against Warden for 49 yards.
49 yards in last second. That was
one of the greatest moments in RB football history.
Oh, yeah. A 49-yard game-winning field goal is insane. It's even insane for professionals to hit a 49-yarder to win it.
Unless you're Justin Tucker.
Yeah, oh, 66 yards.
As Martin coming off the field.
Looks like it's his right leg.
Yeah, this RB team has they have 36 guys on their team.
Yeah.
And you've lost five of them for the year. Four of them have been ACL injuries.
Yeah.
And then Maeda's hurt. It's just...
It's very sad to see. Especially with being ACL, which is a very long recovery. So, yeah. And a lot of these guys play multiple sports. So, horrible to see.
Sure, as Sloan drops back to throw, he's going to have Novak. Novak's going to break a tackle. Still on his feet. Tackled at the 27-yard line. First down for the Bulldogs.
Great play there from TJ Sloan, finding Ryan Novak up the sideline.
Ryan Novak did a great job of getting wide open right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, he was wide open, and that moves the chains for a Bulldogs first down. Looks like the Bulldogs are running like a no huddle somewhat, so.
Sloan under pressure, trying to get away from it. Breaks free. He's going to throw for Toomey, and it's just a little underthrown. But good job by TJ to get rid of that ball.
Yes.
Because he was being chased down by a couple defenders, so on that you just got to not lose
get the ball away. Yes. And which he did, he got outside the pocket and basically threw it away. He tried to get it to Toomey, but it was more of a throwaway than a try to completion, because that is a very tough throw rolling out and full speed.
And
too.
Toomey was pretty covered there, too.
Yeah, he was blanketed, basically. So now that leaves a 2nd and 10 for the Bulldogs.
Sloan drops back again. He's
Sloan's pass incomplete.
Must have been a miscommunication between Toomey and Sloan because there was no one there.
Maybe Vaya and I think it was meant for Vaya. Maybe he was going to run a hitch.
Like, I saw him look at Toomey and Toomey just
stopped running, or
I think Toomey went the other way.
Oh, okay. Miscommunication. You never know whose fault that is, but At least a third and 10 now for the Bulldogs.
Getting a third down conversion would be huge. It'd
oh, my gosh.
Something that the Bulldogs need to feed off of in the
yes,
playoffs,
for
getting
sure.
these third down conversions.
Yeah.
As they give to Novak, give it to Petrucci. Petrucci gets a gain of nine, just short of the first down,
yeah.
but that's a big play.
That
now,
is a big
now
play.
Now it's fourth and one.
A little reverse, the second time we've seen it this game, and it's worked for the Bulldogs. But
as Petrucci seems to be limping off the field.
Yeah, he.
Fourth down and a yard to go.
They're going to call a timeout. RB's going to call a timeout. Let's see what's wrong with Petrucci.
It looked like it might have been an ankle.
Yeah. But great run from Petrucci. And he just needs a little break here. It doesn't seem like he's going to go to Fry for a checkup, but. He's trying to walk it off.
He looks like he's in some pain, though,
yeah,
for
he's,
sure.
He's a tough kid, but.
Only a sophomore, big part of this Bulldog team.
Yeah.
He had very good game against
St. Edward's
the last game we did.
He made
his first career varsity touchdown.
Mm-hmm. And it was a great catch. It was very, very good game. I think he had about five or six catches, too. A lot of screen passes he caught. But he's very good in open space.
Yeah, the Bulldogs are very high up on him.
Yes.
And a lot of their sophomores, Kamskis as well, and Gutierrez, they're very high up on their sophomores. And why not? They are the future of this team, and
yeah.
they look good.
They do look good.
As fourth and one, Toomey and Novak in the backfield. They give it to Novak. Novak's going to fight for these yards. Going to be pushed forward for the first down. Brought down at the 16.
And he is there for a first down. I mean, 73, Jared Salzman was there for the tackle. But, I mean, Novak keeping them legs churning. And the offensive line getting a little push for a first down.
Give it the big men love. Brady's going to take a shot downfield for Vaya. Vaya makes the catch. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Makes the
wow.
catch over Alex Willis.
Yeah, that
this
was
another Brady Vaya Moss.
Yeah, you just got
year.
Moss on his head. Yeah, that was great. Great placement for.
Second time Brady's done that this year. And
yeah.
Brady is not that big of a target either.
Oh, yeah, he's so athletic. And he climbed the ladder and just caught it over him. And Alexander Willis was hoping for the flag there, but just did not get it. But great, great play there from the Bulldogs.
The Bulldogs kick is good. It's 14-41.
Sloan's done a very good job from placing.
Both quarterbacks have done a good job
yeah.
the second half.
Yeah, Sloan has done a great job with placing the ball to where his receiver has a chance to make a play. Being in the first half with Andrew Callis, where it ended up being a play action. And right there with Vaya ended up making the catch for the touchdown.
I feel like you can take the second half and take it into the postseason.
Oh, yes.
Because this
yes.
third quarter has been a great quarter for the Bulldogs, outscoring Bishop Mack. They've just done a good job of
yeah.
just fixing up those errors.
I mean, the first play being a fumble recovery, and then right after that, Iggy Bielor-Radic touchdown on a screen play, and then that nice long drive to a Bulldogs touchdown after a great return from Vaya and using that to their advantage to get a touchdown, obviously making it 14-41 now.
Definitely anxious to see who the Bulldogs face in the playoffs.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's most likely going to be a high seed. And, yeah, it's going to be a tough, tough matchup for the Bulldogs. But
for sure. But here's the thing with this team. They struggle in the first half.
Yes.
There's teams where they look like they good teams where they either struggle against or they play pretty solidly. They've played the second half against Bishop Mack very solidly, and Bishop Mack has got most of their starters in there.
Uh-huh.
They played St. Francis very well.
Yes.
They played, they lost a tough game to IC, but, I mean, they played them tough as well.
Mm-hmm.
They play teams tough, and they don't quit.
I think also we don't give enough credit to Coach Curtin because obviously his halftime speeches have been productive all year. St. Edwards, that was a tough first half. They were losing at
first
half.
Yeah, they were
half.
Down That was a good game. They just came out in the second half, and they came out fighting.
Yeah. And
because if you remember that first few games of the year, they struggled in the second half.
Yes. Especially the Morton game.
Especially the Morton game.
Being – they were down – or they were up, like, a couple touchdowns, and then Morton, you saw Morton
fight back.
They were
up 20-0, and Morton just fought back.
Yeah.
Morton, yes, they've been historically bad team throughout the years, but they have had a solid year this year.
Yeah, they have had a solid year.
I don't think they're a playoff team. I think they have 3 wins, I want to say. But
they also play a lot of tough teams. So
as Phillips takes the ball, another big run from Phillips.
Gets about 14 yards.
Yeah. It's brought down like right at the 50.
Yeah.
But yeah, Morton's been a much improved team this year.
That's Bishop McNamara first down.
And like we said at the beginning, Bishop Mack needed to win this game so
they could make it in the playoffs.
Yes, yes. So if Bishop Mack ends up winning this game, they will end with the same record as RB. And obviously that would have Bishop Mack a good chance to make in the playoffs. So
yeah, but you also have to keep in mind they're in two different divisions.
Yes, yes.
As Phillips takes another carry. Look at that explosiveness at the 30, the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Bishop Mack. Tony Phillips. How many is that?
5?
Is that number 5?
5 piece? Maybe. Was that 5? I think it is.
I believe that is number 5.
And that's another big run. I mean, about at the 50-yard line, then housed it. He gets there in a hurry. I mean,
he just shows off that speed.
Yeah. It doesn't even look like he's trying to run that fast.
He finds a hole. He's patient. He finds a hole. And once he finds that hole,
he's gone.
He just outruns the secondary.
Yeah. I mean, Bela Bredic, who's, like we said, he's got some wheels. He was outrunning Bela Bredic with ease. So, yes, it's Phillips.
There's a reason he's a diamond in the rough prospect and has 3 D1 offers.
Yeah, as a sophomore.
As a sophomore.
And those 3 teams are, most of them are competitive. I mean, Syracuse isn't the greatest collegiate football team, but
they're solid. Yeah, they're very solid in an
ACC conference with teams like Clemson. And
Clemson's having a very down year. But
yeah, but usually
they're usually like middle of the pack ACC team. They had a good year a couple years ago where they're ranked.
Yeah.
You look at a team like Tennessee, who they are one of the lower level teams in the SEC.
Yeah, but they, I mean,
the tradition of Tennessee football, I mean, they are a historically very good program.
Oh yeah, yes, especially like in that.
I mean, they've had NFL running backs, Alvin Kamara.
Yeah, Alvin Kamara, who was actually a running back at Alabama to start off his collegiate career, but never got in, transferred Tennessee, and obviously.
And Tennessee, it looked like they had Trevor Lawrence too at one point.
Yeah, almost. And then he obviously
ended up going to Clemson
and being the first pick of the most recent NFL draft. So
Tennessee does produce talent, and he's been getting interest from Michigan, who's a top 10 team, and Illinois.
Yes.
Ooh, Illinois can use all the help they can get.
Especially this year.
They are not very good.
No, they they had high – I mean, their fans had high hopes for them, but ended up not
Bieler Brock returned to the 20.
Succeeding
to the 30 is brought down at the 37.
Solid return there from Bieler Brock.
They've had solid returns all night.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, the special teams for Bishop Mack is –
And that's what I feel will cost them in those close games and in the playoffs.
Yeah,
mental errors and special teams.
Yeah, your takeaways for was penalties, dumb penalties, because I'm pretty sure they had 1 unsportsmanlike conduct at the end of the play, which
3 blocks in the backs.
Yes.
Couple false starts.
Yeah, they've had a lot of penalties, but those are the things you have to erase as a football team, is dumb penalties.
Petrucci takes the handoff. Trying to find some open room. He gets a hole and makes something out of nothing. He's still on his feet and is brought down at the 45, a gain of 7, where it looked like he maybe had a yard.
Yeah. Petrucci, great patience there, waiting for his blocks to set, and explodes up the field for a solid gain of 6 or 7. I mean, those are the plays that you need to take advantage of, is first down plays getting more than 5 yards. So then on second and short, you can maybe extend the field and go deep.
As it looks like Nate Padilla is in the backfield.
Getting Ryan Novak a little break.
Yeah, Ryan Novak plays offense and defense. Give him a little rest. Low snap. Sloan falls on top of it. No, he does not. Padilla somehow picks it up. He's on his feet. The whistle is blown. I don't think his knee touched the ground.
No, he was laying. I'm pretty sure he was laying down when he caught possession of the ball.
I don't think he ever had possession of it.
Maybe not. But they're going to call it that he was down there.
There'll be a loss on that play.
So all of a sudden, third and three, or second and three, turns into third and 13.
Third down and 13.
I don't think that he had possession of that ball.
Hard to see it from up here, but obviously the ref saw it.
But great awareness for Padilla to pick up that ball.
And try to make
a play out of it.
Positive yards or even get back in the line there. So
it looked like he had a first down there.
Yeah, maybe.
Pick that up. He had a lot of open field. As Sloan takes it. Throw in for Kumskis. It is broken up by Alex Willis, who had just gotten mossed by Brady Vaya.
Incomplete. That'll bring up a fourth down for the Bulldogs.
Yeah.
Makes the play on defense on Kumskis as the punt team is out once again.
Seems like we've said that a lot this game, but not this half as much.
No.
Like you said, they have to take this second half into the postseason
and try
to build off of it.
This has been a slow third quarter. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah,
it's still a third quarter with 49 seconds left.
Yeah. It seems like we've been in the third quarter forever.
Really, it has been. As Bela Braddock kicks it. Another solid punt. Turns it from the 30. As Callis is there for the tackle.
Number 25, Jackson Roberts.
Jackson Roberts with the solid return there.
Jackson Roberts at 5'4".
And a fan favorite, Ricky McDonald, getting into this game now. The senior who was homecoming king, yeah.
I'm not going to lie to you, Jake. I'm kind of cold up here in the press box.
It is a little chilly.
I'm questioning your decision to keep the window open.
I don't know. I mean, I was like, oh, it's comfortable. We're wearing long sleeves.
It was comfortable effort. And I'm wearing a jacket. You're not wearing a jacket.
Yeah, I'm not even. My feet are freezing. But when you're out playing, it's the cold really doesn't play an effect unless
it's
very cold.
No wide receivers here. As another just punch it up the gut,
yeah,
from Bishop Mack, and gain of 4.
With this weather, I mean, it's football weather.
It is football weather.
It's football weather. And I mean, I'm chilly, but I'm chilling, I should say. And that will probably be the quarter.
That'll finally end the third quarter. A lot of positives to take away from the Bulldogs there.
Yeah.
But defense,
that'll be the last play.
It's
the
not even that they're playing that bad. It's just Tony Phillips.
Yeah.
He's just levels beyond everyone else on this field.
Yes.
He's by far the best player on the field.
And you could tell. I mean,
you could just tell.
Yeah. Like, going back to all his touchdowns, two being over 50 yards.
Two being over 75 yards.
Oh, two being, yes. And
I think he's had three over 50 yards,
yeah,
I want to say.
He had that 50-yard run last, and then those two big runs. And then the other two, one being inside the 5 and the other being inside the 20. But, yeah, it's just he's just there. It's barely like he barely gets touch on those.
He
you
barely
know?
Does get touch.
Like he finds the hole and just explodes through the secondary into the end zone. So we were talking about him a lot in the beginning of the game and before the game, and yeah, I mean, for good reason. So yeah, he's very talented. And now they're going to start at the
–
Bishop Maximus start at the 46-yard line now.
Second and 5 from their own 46-yard line.
Looks like they're waiting to start and waiting for a signal. Looks like – oh, they're – Kumskis is bleeding. I think that's why. There's a little stoppage. He looks to be fine.
He's fine. Just a little bleed.
A little tough burn.
But IHSA rules are, if you have blood on you, you can't play
then
until it gets.
You have to come out of the game for at least a play.
So the blood is taken care of. Especially now with COVID. That's probably a good idea.
Yeah.
As Phillips takes the carry. He's brought down in the backfield.
Great
Nate
play there.
Nate Padilla is back there with Jack Rivetti.
Brian Twomey on the stop.
Jack Rivetti, a sophomore.
He hasn't played a lot, but he's very talented sophomore. Very good defender as well. He's very gritty and will make a lot of tackles for this Bulldogs team in the future.
Third down and seven.
Now third and seven here. Seeing if a Bulldogs can make a stop here. And Bishop Mack's starters are still in the game, so they're keeping their
foot
on the gas pedal.
Yeah. Reputation of running up the score and. Not afraid to do that.
Yep.
Padilla is in the backfield. It's somehow makes the play to the fullback.
And that's
a first down.
Wow.
Pass is complete.
That is Mel Hay. Have not called his name all day.
Yeah. That was a great
Padilla was in the backfield. It looks like Bertrand was about to be brought down, but not to be. What a play from Bertrand.
I mean, he was about to get tackled, and with obviously he just chucked it right to him. I mean, great play there to make a first down for Bishop Mack.
As no wide receivers again for Bishop Mack. The give to Phillips. And patient runner gets 4 yards looking for more, but could not get anything there.
Yeah.
Honestly, let him throw the ball.
Yeah.
Give him a handoff, let him throw the ball, see what he could do.
Maybe.
As it looks like Bertrand is coming out of the game, and here comes Jeremy Deuce Alloway.
Jeremy Deuce.
Second best number two with the nickname Deuce, only behind Colin Cash. Let's see, Deuce has three running backs behind him. Let's see what he can do.
I like how you refer him as Deuce.
That's what it says here.
It does. On the roster.
That's what it says in the roster is.
Jay Don right on the carry.
Give the fullback right.
And really no gain there, but.
Give him 2 yards.
Now that brings
two.
Yeah, third and short.
Third down. 2 yards to go.
Deuce got the play. He's going, he's coming to the huddle.
I love this.
Don't get a lot of nicknames here on the roster, so fun to see one.
Oh, for sure. Especially one like Deuce. Jeremy Deuce, that's one I was not expecting to see today.
Yeah.
As Wright takes the carry.
Jadon Wright with
gain
the carry.
Gain of four. I don't know if we should be calling him Deuce, though. It's like the announcer's calling Khalil Herbert
Juice.
Yeah, but
switch it up
sometimes.
Switch it up.
You see.
Let's have some fun.
You see like a guy like King Henry.
King Henry.
I mean, after that game against the Bills.
Yeah.
Give him the MVP. Give it to him. My fantasy carrier.
Congratulations, Jake. So happy you won your fantasy football. As ball's loose on the ground, Marcus Turner is fighting for it, but looks like it was recovered by Bishop Mack.
Yeah, I mean, going back to my fantasy, like everyone wants to hear that. But, I mean, Derrick Henry, give him the MVP right now. Give it to him.
Oh, really?
Yes. Yeah, but Bishop Mack now second and long. Great stop there from the Bulldogs on the run play. And I'm guessing they're just going to run the clock as well as run the ball. And, it looks like no wide receiver sets again.
As the handoff to Wright. Right, struck down by Turner.
Trying to give him
that was Moody. Not exactly.
Try to give him the stiff arm, the King Henry special, I like to call it. But
I think you're referring to Derrick Henry a little bit too.
I know.
Much
I'm
in
sorry.
Broadcast.
I'm sorry. He's one of like my favorite players.
Congrats, you won fantasy football this week. You're now 1-5.
No biggie. I'm 5-1 actually.
Okay.
Come on now.
Okay, buddy. Here we go. 3rd and 7 here. No wide receivers again on a 3rd and medium.
Do you think you see a 4th down?
As Deuce has got to keep it. Breaks the tackle from Padilla. On his feet. Deuce is going to be brought out of bounds.
Yeah, I mean.
Jack Rivetti brought him out, but not before the 1st down.
Padilla makes a great play, but does not execute the tackle. But that's a tough tackle there from
a
player's standpoint. And the clock is now running with 6 minutes and 45 seconds left.
I'd love to give a shout-out to our camera operator, Matt Morgan, right now, who he looks like he's freezing right now. The only camera operator
on the
outside
field.
The press box right now. The only one on the field. He is enduring the elements.
Yes.
Not the strongest jacket in the world, but shout-out to Matt. He's sticking through it.
Yeah.
As they give to Wright. Breaking a couple tackles, still on his feet. And he's brought down by Petrucci right at the 1 yard line.
1 yard line. I mean, Wright is. It's funny because you see Phillips and then you see Wright. They're basically polar opposite running backs. Wright being a guy who basically runs the ball.
225 and Phillips is 5'6", 170.
Yeah. Wright being more of a downhill runner, and I mean, Phillips does. Run.
Phillips is more of like a patient runner,
yes,
though. He's not gonna
run you over
right
it, but right.
He's just
is.
Gonna wait, find the open hole, then take it.
Yes.
And he'll break a couple tackles along the way. Yeah. Run past you. As Deuce is gonna leap forward for the touchdown.
Jeremy Deuce with the touchdown.
Deuce Alloway the 2nd makes it a 54-14 game.
Now with 5 minutes and 30 seconds left in this game. And RB trying, at least getting the ball back here.
As there is a Bishop Mack fan running around the track with a Bishop Mack flag.
Wow.
Jackson Mills. That is hilarious.
And it's not a close commute from
Kankakee,
yeah.
About an hour and a half.
Yeah. So dedication.
Not a fun drive, but a big one will make that. Bus ride home a little fun.
Yeah.
As the kick is blocked by Ricky McDonald.
Hey. Great play there from McDonald's there to
McDonald's.
No, McDonald. Sorry. And now it's only 54-14. I mean, better than 55. Better than 55.
5:35 remaining in the ball game.
Yeah, instead of 40, it's 41. Or instead of 41, it's 40.
With that 40-point advantage, the rest of this game will play under a running clock. Once the kickoff
now it's a running clock, and
is put into play.
Unless there is another score from RB, the clock will continue to run. All right, takeaways for Bulldogs: positive and negatives.
Negative.
Could
not stop the run.
Yes. And
gotta stop 3rd down.
Yes. And positives?
Offense looked great. I'm not going to say great, but the offense looked solid the 2nd half.
Yeah.
We had a lot of good signs from both quarterbacks. Iggy Beeler-Braddock had a great, great 2nd half.
And then
that defense
also
made some big stops for some turnovers.
Yeah. And
they could definitely feed into.
Special teams is also a big positive for the Bulldogs.
Oh, for sure.
And then kickoff here from Bishop Mack. Brady Vaya getting the return now.
Vaya returning from 13, 25, the 30, he still has to be the 35, the 40, the 45, the 50. One man to beat, the kicker tries stiff arming him and he's brought down at the 33. You just mentioned special teams.
I mean, great return there from Vaya. He's getting, he turned on the Jets and the kicker was the
Alex
only guy
Willis,
left.
The last line of defense was the one to, there, as, uh-oh. Uh-oh, that might have been a flag on Owen Murphy as there's an injury on the field.
It looks like it's Faya, too.
Oh, that. Tenecott shoved Willis, I saw there. And I guess Murphy, who you don't see him act like that at all.
No.
And good for Murph, honestly.
Yeah. And the refs
that
are.
That was.
Yeah.
Dead ball penalty, unsportsmanlike contact against the Bulldogs.
There's unsportsmanlike against the Bulldogs. I don't know if they called it on Toomey or they called it on Murphy.
Yeah. It seemed like they could have called a late hit there, and that's what caused Vaya's injury because he got into the track, and I think he might have. With this covering of the track, you lose that grip, and it looks like he might have hurt his lower half, maybe his leg. So
he is not a guy you can afford to lose right now.
No, not at all. And he really hasn't moved since.
It's terrible.
Yeah, it is horrible.
As Padilla gets the carry, and Padilla with a big run there. Gain of 10 and a Bulldog first down.
Padilla, put him in the game, and he's bringing a little energy to this Bulldogs team at the end of the game. And after a great return, put the ball in the zone. That's what the Bulldogs are trying to do, obviously.
Because the main concern here is Brady Vaya. He's starting to get up, and hopefully it's not too severe, but it looks like he's barely putting any weight on his ankle.
Yeah. High snap.
Padilla takes it again. Look at the speed for Padilla at the 30, right down to 28. He was marked down before losing the football.
Nice run. A couple of nice runs from Padilla there. And that is a Bulldogs first down.
First and 10, Riverside Brookfield.
Faya now slowly going to midfield now, and he's
heading towards the trainer's table.
Yeah.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
Hopefully he's all right and can play for the playoffs.
Yeah.
But that's just the late injuries you cannot afford.
No, not at all. And it was on a plate that was already dead, basically.
As Gutierrez is going to make the throw towards Tenecott. It's incomplete.
Incomplete.
He was going to try and take off there, but he had nowhere to go.
Very good position to try to continue this drive and get points on the board.
Agreed. There's running clock with 2 minutes left. Espedia once again lined up in the backfield. Let's see if you give him another carry because he's been carrying the load on this drive. As Gutierrez throwing deep for Tenecott. Tenecott cannot come up with it.
Got both hands on it, but he got drilled.
There were two defenders.
Yeah. It was a very, very solid throw from Diego, but obviously too good of coverage for a catch there. But Tenecott, at least Diego got him, got the ball up there and
gave him a chance.
Gave him his chance, yes, exactly.
Third down and 10.
Diego, no running backs.
Adrian Morales is lined up at the bottom of the screen. Diego under pressure. Looks like he gets rid of it. He
was
already
out of bounds. Yeah.
He was ruled out of bounds.
Which might have prevented that interception.
Yeah.
At the 37
yard line.
Fourth down.
This is going to be the last play of the game.
Yep.
Take a shot at the end zone. Why not?
Yep.
There's 25 seconds.
Or at least take a shot at this. Take a shot at the end zone, basically. And that's what I'm guessing Coach
Even if it's incomplete.
Yeah.
I believe the clock still runs.
It does.
Because there is 10 seconds left here as Gutierrez Drops back to throw for Kumskis. Kumskis makes the catch. Short of the first down, but that'll end the game. Your final score, Bishop Mack 54, Riverside Brookfield 14. Tough game for the Bulldogs. They fought back, did a great job in that second half, and they definitely have something to feed off of into the playoffs.
Yes.
However, the loss of Brady Via is a big loss for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, he still looks in horrible pain on the trainer's table.
So that's definitely going to be our main concern.
Yes. Because he is a huge part of this offense.
He is a huge part of the Bulldogs team.
His team, yeah, in general.
Well, we thank you for tuning into the RBTV Game of the Week. Once again, your final score, Bishop Mack 54, Bulldogs 14. We thank you for tuning in tonight and for all this football season. And we will see what happens with the Bulldogs in the playoffs. Thank you for tuning in, and good night, everybody.